been studying Hindustani music with Hari Prasad Charazia in Bombay. I got a grant to study abroad there, and I've been there for 1 year. I'm hoping to go back again. He's been one of my favorite musicians to listen to for many years. So I started collecting his CDs when I was in high school, and I would listen to them all the time and try to play along with them. So it's been one of my goals to study with him for a very long time. I've been studying Western classical music for, I think, 12 years now. I was very interested in jazz for a long time and the idea of jazz improvisation and kind of the ideal of improvisation in music. I felt very kind of confined by Western classical notation and the whole approach. And I really wanted to improvise. So I was really into jazz. That was kind of in high school. And when I was in that period, I came across some recordings of one of my favorite musicians, John McLaughlin. And he made recordings called Shakti and Remember Shakti. And this was an Indian fusion group. So it was him. He plays jazz guitar. Zakir Hussain on tabla. And Hari Prasad Chaurasia on flute. And those recordings were very influential to me. I really loved them. I listened to them all the time. I tried to kind of learn from them. And at first, I thought it was like a great combination of jazz improvisation and Indian improvisation. And I thought that, like, you know, the jazz part of it was what made it great. But the more I listened to it, the more I realized that actually it was the Indian approach that was really coming across to me and really spoke to me. So after that, I started collecting recordings of Hari Prasad Charazia and Ali Akbar Khan and other Hindustani musicians, and Zakir Hussain, especially Zakir Hussain. In terms of improvisation, it seems kind of like the ultimate in like improvised construction. Just the way they can take one rag, one musical mode or scale, and one time signature and draw it out into a very full piece of music that can last anywhere from 40 minutes to 2 hours and not have it be boring. It's incredibly well thought out and kind of the perfect balance of improvisation and composition, like complete understanding of the music. You know, to be able to make a performance not boring for 2 hours is hard in itself, but then have it to just be one piece, it's pretty amazing. I definitely have a lot of favorite ragas. Right now I'm exploring Jai Javanti. It's one of my favorite ragas at the moment. Shankar, that name was given to me by my guru, Amma. So she gave me that name when I was in fourth grade. I was nine, and I thought it was really cool that she gave me a name, and I went by it ever since. And that's what everybody calls me, Shankar. So I definitely come from a family of artists. Both my parents are visual artists. My mom paints, and my dad is a sculptor, both by profession. And my grandfather is very musical. He's a composer, and he plays a whole bunch of different instruments. He was my first teacher. He taught me piano and clarinet. I don't know, you know, general composition. And clarinet is really my instrument. That's the instrument that I practice. I took piano lessons when I was younger, and I can play a bit of piano, just enough to get by. And I can sort of play tabla and ganjira and bass, but honestly, I wouldn't say that I have any real skill on any of those other instruments. So I started when I was 10, I think, and I took weekly classical lessons all the way up through college. I got my degree, my bachelor's degree in classical clarinet performance. So that's obviously a huge musical influence. I played a lot of jazz for a while in high school and college, and then Indian music, which has been a growing portion of my musical influence. The Shruti Box is an online series of musical videos, which I've been producing. I try to define it as an online music show. I'm getting more and more into working with singers. I've done some instrumental pieces, but I'm really enjoying working with a large range of vocalists that I continue to meet. So, and I try to cover a wide range of Indian musical styles, from semi-classical music to Indian kind of folk traditions to Indian popular music and film songs, and kind of I'm really trying to spread it out. I've done some songs before with Vidya and Vandana Iyer, who are great South Indian singers, and now I'm trying to also throw in a lot of North Indian influence. I'm really trying to work with a wide range, you know. A lot of people have been contacting me, and then they send me a link to their stuff, and if they're close by and they sound good, then I try to collaborate with them and make it work. I do have some dreams. I mean, it depends on, honestly, it depends on fundraising at this point, but, like, if I could work with somebody like Shankar Mahadevan or Zakir Hussain, you know, that would be a dream come true. I hope to be able to keep playing music because I, you know, I love it, and it's kind of inspired me to do everything so far. It's the driving force, and I hope to, you know, use the videos to be able to kind of really segue into the professional world.